LEGO just can't really seem to figure it out. So on June 1st, a ton of new LEGO sets came out, but possibly the biggest one that came out was the new LEGO set from Lord of the Rings, the Tower Barad-dûr. Both figuratively and literally, this is one of the biggest sets to come out this year because it's the first from LEGO Lord of the Rings, and it's just a big guy. So LEGO thought, let's do something special. So if you bought the Tower of Barad-dûr within the first couple of days, as a VIP, you would get the LEGO Fel Beast completely for free. And just on the surface, hey, this is like a fun idea. If you buy a set, you get a free little LEGO set. You know, that's fun with a free little build that goes with the LEGO set. But it didn't stay like this for very long, because this promo sold out in under 24 hours and now is going for upwards of $200 on eBay. And this is insane, because if you just bought the LEGO set day one as a VIP, you got this for free. You don't have to pay anything extra for this. And now people are going on the aftermarket and paying almost half the price of the original set for a set with less than 30 pieces that you got for free. This just needs to end. I talk about LEGO exclusivity all the time, and this is why, because they just keep screwing over their fans. Lord of the Rings is a huge fandom, and now there are only three LEGO sets from it that came out recently. $500 LEGO set, $460 LEGO set, and a LEGO set that you could only get for the first 20 hours of buying a $460 LEGO set, which now goes for upwards of $200 and will probably go for more in the future. What? This is just horrible. Like, I'm not saying gift with purchases are bad. I think gift with purchases are one of the most fun things that LEGO does. But when it's this extreme, like, LEGO finally made a small Lord of the Rings set, the thing that we've been asking for so long, and they find another way to put it behind a $400 paywall. Like, seriously, if they released this set in Target, $30, do you know how many of them would sell? We'll probably buy duplicates so they get an entire army of ring wraiths. Like, it would sell so well. You could even stinking overprice it. You could probably sell this for $40 and it'd still sell great. But no, they have to put it behind a paywall. And now I'm hoping that they will make this right by this being a bit of a test of smaller stuff, and then next year they're just bringing a whole wave. That would make it okay. But this is just kind of giving me the lightsaber builds from Star Wars vibes, where everyone is asking for lightsabers for so long, and then LEGO Star Wars is like, okay, spend $600 and you can get one for free. That's just not how such a popular thing should be. I use the example of the Lars family kitchen all the time, because it's just a perfect gift with purchase. Because only the people who really care about that are the people who are willing to pay the money to get it. Because it's so obscure, not every Star Wars fan is going to want a kitchen. Like, it's just something that the diehard fans, who are probably already buying the big set, will get for a fun little bonus. But a Ringwraith and a Fel Beast, and this being the only small set with Lord of the Rings, like, everyone who's ever seen or read Lord of the Rings is gonna want this. Because even if you don't have space for the other ones, this is tiny. You could fit it on a shelf and it'd look awesome. But it's half the price of a giant, beautiful masterpiece of a LEGO set for this thing. And LEGO just keeps doing this over and over and over again, and I just don't know, like, when are they gonna try and change it? Are they not? Are they just completely content with, like, 70% of the fan base having absolutely nothing and then just being annoyed about it, which they honestly kind of should be? Just because you don't have stinking $460 to buy a giant LEGO set day one doesn't mean you shouldn't be able to buy LEGO Lord of the Rings. And hopefully this will finally be the thing that breaks LEGO into making small Lord of the Rings sets, because I don't see too many people that are happy about this. Same thing, if they release smaller LEGO sets with Barad-dûr, no one would care about this. It would just be a fun bonus thing for that set. But because of the circumstances with no small Lord of the Rings set, it just makes LEGO seem even worse, because they make one and they just give it to the people who are already spending $500. And it's not bad if you're buying the tower, it's awesome. I just feel like it should also be, like, available for everyone. For example, you can make more Lord of the Rings sets without putting Sauron in every single one. Leave him exclusive to the tower, and then just put all the more popular characters in every set. There you go. Someone who bought the tower gets something really cool and exclusive. Someone who just wants the smaller sets and doesn't care that much, boom, they get stuff. Like, I feel like it's not that hard. And obviously, I don't know. I don't work in marketing or business, but, like, it just seems pretty obvious to me and a lot of people that LEGO would make a crap ton of money if they would just make Lord of the Rings sets, and people would be so much happier with them if they just made small Lord of the Rings sets. This shows clearly they can do it. We already knew they could. They gave us one. Like, this is what small Lord of the Rings would be. But of course, it can't just stay at that. And now, 95% of Lord of the Rings fans aren't going to be able to get this unless they want to spend a stupid amount of money on the aftermarket or they're lucky enough to get a day one. And that sucks. Like, I feel horrible about that because, like, no one should have to go through an entire fandom owned by LEGO and you can't even get a single set from it because of how expensive they are. That's just not how it should be. There should always be exclusive stuff. There should always be cheap stuff. And LEGO just doesn't seem to understand that. I don't know if anything I said made sense in this video. It was really reactionary, but it's just, LEGO cannot figure out Lord of the Rings. The sets they make are just so beautiful, and I would just love to see more people be able to get them, because it's genuinely sad every time I see a $500 LEGO set come out, and then all the people complain because they can't afford it. Like, it's just sad. It's just a bummer. I wish more people could get them. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know what your opinions on this are in the comments down below. I would love to hear everyone's take. Thank you so much for watching. LEGO, make smaller Lord of the Rings sets, please. It is all I want. And I will see you next time, hopefully next week. Goodbye.